this piece of paper about that.
Like so. You don't have to worry about keeping these because the new trim sets usually come with them. So
is this going to go on charge?
Yep. Get out. Just remember, swearing is okay. You're allowed to. If you don't swear while installing these, you're not human.
Well, someone we know even got an injury to their head.
We don't talk about that. Right, so, easy way is, well, the easiest. You put in this front edge first, the front of the door edge. Just put it in there, then get the back, get this back edge in. You want the whole frame to go down further than it needs to, so that this top edge here, you got to bend it slightly in to get it in all the way. Now, here's where it gets a bit tricky. If you let this drop, it's gonna like warp the panel because it's very, very flimsy. So just get a bit of tape. And then get another bit of tape because your tape's stuck to each other. Okay. Put it on the outside of this. Loop it around and just have it loosely sitting there, just so you can still move it around, but it's not going to fall down and warp, break something or bend. Okay, so what I need to do is getting in here, pulling it back slightly, lining up all the holes. Right, just probably start off from this side. So that tab, the tab that's on here, bend that around so that it can't really go anywhere. Then you just using your fingers to lightly click down. Taking care to this glass. Let's go back a bit further. Right. Just looking, carefully looking at where all the clips are sitting. Now one here is actually bent in, so it's not going inside of the hole properly. So you've got to get a really tiny, a baby screwdriver, and without touching the trim itself, just going down and hold, like flicking it back slightly so that it goes in. Before clicking any of these in, you want to make sure that they're all going into the hole which they're supposed to. Right, so click. All right, so that's these in. Now comes the difference between, this is why we prefer Wolfsburg West. As you can see, or probably not see because this tripod is so annoying, the hole on the cutout hole for the aluminium there is lined up with the hole of the doors. Flick this around. Anyway, you can see that. But if you get cheap ones, they will not they will either not have any cutout for the Bailey channel clips, or they'll be in the wrong areas. Yeah, exactly. Because it's just
that's probably what you're facing. Be quiet,
you're not allowed to say anything. I'm the one who videos. Right. Oh god. Right. Yeah, so you'll have to very carefully with a drill bit and maybe like an 8mm size drill bit, drill through the aluminium where drill through the aluminium into the hole where the Bailey channel clip is on the inside. Right. So now for the Bailey clips. Now I find with these, happens all the time and it's infuriating. This plate that has the holes in them, if I can lower it, I might lower the thing a bit so you can see properly. Right. The plate that the strip of metal that is in between these two holes and one of the holes is a part of, it bends in sometimes, and when you push the clips in, it actually will push the clips in and underneath and so flip out on an angle. So hang on, I'll give you an example. If you're doing this, try your best to salvage the original Bailey channel clips, which look like so this is what the original ones look like. As you can see, they're quite short, very elegant, beautiful. And this is the new ones you can buy. They're a lot longer and a bit of a pain to deal with, honestly. Because they come welded on these two edges here. And if you put too much pressure on them, they're going to either snap or... But when you're putting it in, if you put it in too far, it'll sort of like slide in. I don't want to try and explain to you how it does it in, how it goes in, but if it flips in, what to do, but it probably will happen. Anyway, so getting the new channel. Phone call. Right. Now this clip, you want the to go in that way. So this outer edge here, you want that to be going this way, and then on the bottom, you want the bottom to be going that way. If you have both clips going one way, or going either one way or the other, it actually means it makes it prone to moving the what is that? Oh, you're singing. So you just want to be sliding it in. That's going to happen.
Now why? What's the biggest problems with the new clips? It's not so much the size, is it? It's that they snap. Would you agree?
Well, would you?
The little flap on the clip just snaps off too easy.
Right, so basically the goal is to get that bent lip through the hole. It's if nothing's lining up properly, it's going to be very hard to do. But if you are not confident in this sort of thing, then it's always best to get some masking tape and run it along the outside of the aluminium strip and probably on the painted side as well. That will avoid sometimes, yeah, it'll avoid it scratches as much as possible. So just get the mallet and the screwdriver, doesn't really matter which, it's got a cheap one here. Have put the end of the screwdriver in the thing, in the hole. Looking at that, let's start off with this bottom one. Right, you want to be hitting it down to make sure that the clip goes inside of the this is infuriating. At this point you can feel free to say some swear words. Oh golly gosh.
Oh blimey.
Core blimey, mate. Right. So the problem I'm having is the hole here is actually too low for these bailey channels. When you push this little edge in, it just wants to suck the whole thing inside. So I'll just get a hook tool, get it, pull it through the hole, and then using leverage, just running the hook around and bending the hole back this way. This is one thing that you're better off doing before this goes on, but sometimes it might seem all right, but it does not be all right. Right, it's a bit twisted, but it seems to be going in. Now, just very light taps to see how it behaves. Now, as you can see, it's on a really big angle. So you want to try and get your fingers and pull it back till it's even. Right, now you can see that it's on a really, oh God, let's drop it a bit more. Yes, we are professionals. I'm a professional. Right. Now, as you can see, the tab is fully in. Can't see very well because of the bloody light, but it's on a fair bit of an angle. If you look on the top edge, hard to see because of the bloody lights, but the edge of the clip is barely on the edge of... Oh, Oh, that didn't really help. It's barely on the edge of there, of the metal, which means if you try and push a clip in there, it's just gonna push that in all the way. So what to do in this situation, just start off by getting your fingers, watching out with, better off wearing gloves, watching out for the spikes on the clip. Just try and bending it down so that it brings the this top edge back in. It doesn't matter if there's a bit of flex in it, as long as, yeah. Right, so there's a bit of a gap there, but when you put the felt clip in, it'll, hard to see, but yeah, it'll settle in when it's in. All right, now we do this side. Now I'll show you the difference. Don't really want to sacrifice a new one, an old clip, because they're so precious, but for demonstration's sake, this is the original clip, the short one. So it just goes in there, as you can see. So you get it started, get the flathead screwdriver and the tap. Be careful to not tap it on the, there you can see a bit of the aluminium in the hole there. Make sure just to tap above it, just a few light taps, and that's in. That's how much. Oh, yep. So even that is not acceptable. So you can see the this comes down to the bendy, so you can see that, well, you can't really, but it's barely touching the metal bit, so we have to bend the hole back out. It is in there, but as soon as you try and clip a rubber into it, it'll go and then be absolutely ruined. So to taking them out is a bit harder. There's a little notch there. Just sort of give it a light tap to slide it back out. These go in a lot easier for some reason than the newer ones. I think it's probably because of the length of them. Right, so we get the hook tool. Slide it in there. Give it a bend. Like that. Clip goes in. Light tap. There. And that's how it's done. So now, because this bloody thing. So I don't know if you can see, the clip is well and truly over the top of the inner frame there. That's what you want, so that when you push it, when you push the felt channel in, it's not going to like push in and create all sorts of havoc. Right, now I'm going to take a breather and then I will put the rest of these clips in. I'll probably end up using the hook tool and bending all the tabs out anyway, because that just makes it a whole lot easier. But I'm noticing already, that's something that you gotta watch out for. If you accidentally bend it a little bit, it's not the end of the world, because when you fold that clip back in, it straightens it back out. But just don't kink it. Also already noticing that the gap here is way too small to put the clips in. The gap between here is way too small to put clips in, so I'll show you how to solve that problem. Right. Let's give this a go, shall we? So our issue is when you put this in here, the shape of, if I can move this without, there's a really tiny gap there that literally need to stretch it open to be able to get a clip in there. So let's give that a go. So there's three clips in total to put in here. You don't put this end one in until the quarter window goes in, because if you put that clip in, it makes it difficult to lever the quarter across, which I'll show you soon. So we'll start off with this one. So as you can see, when you set that in there, there's like hardly any gap there. So what to do? Let's try this first. Being very careful not to bend the trim. Just remember, if you accidentally scratch it, as long as it's on this inner channel, then it's not the end of the world, because, well, you're not going to see it. But to get this in here, it's going to be a very painful task. So what I might do is I might actually start off by putting this one in. That's way too big. Right. Leave the clip out. Remember, this is being taken back out, so to widen the trim enough to get the clip in, like so. Close it in. So as you can see, it's actually crimped down a lot. But there's not much we can do about that, so what I'll do is I'll leave that like that for now. I won't put it all away because it'll make it difficult to take back out. Right, I've got the hook tool here. Get it around, sort of lift it out so that, twist it around so that the hook part is facing up. And then just levering like so, put a bit of pressure in it, move it around to the side slightly. It's better than what it was. Let's give it a go. Get the clip. Now, because it's hard to go in that way, we'll go in this way. As you can see, it's too wide to actually put in, so we get the clip out, lever it up. Oh, let's do it right here. Widen the hole. Right, just get it sitting in there for now. We'll work out where the hole's further along, so we'll start off by trying to tap it across. Oh no, there goes my power aid. Right, so the lever's actually started to go in the hole, which is a very good sign, so we can finish this tapping it in. This is where the new clips suck. Right, so yeah, that's where you want it. So you want the tab, that inner bit to be fully in the hole and not being able to see any of it. So that's in far enough. Now we'll get this middle one in. This is going to be the hardest one. So we'll get the hook tool. Must have been the wind. Hook tool through. Bloody hoodie. Give that a go. Now we'll go that way, we'll go that way, and that way has gone that way. So I will go this way on this one. So holding this up, getting that in behind there, lever it out. Getting it to about where the hole is, and then closing it back up. Now we just lightly tap until So what I've done there is the tab. The tab has actually hasn't gone into the hole. Maybe we'll get a new GoPro one day. Anyway, it's missed the hole and gone slidden in underneath the chrome trim instead. So we just got to bloody put it on that tab there, knock it back. A bit more. Right, so now we want to put the screwdriver on the tab itself. Tap it down and then try again sliding it back across. Nope. Ooh. Right, so I've gone in, but it's gone out too far. There we go. Who would know that this would be so easy, you know? Not anyone can do it. Not having any troubles whatsoever. The door would be finished. Yeah. If everything went in perfectly as it should every time, this doing one single door would probably take an hour maybe. But nothing.
Most shops take about a day.
Well,
a day per door is standard.
You can't just assume that. Nope.
No, still. It was on the podcast. They said it before.
Not everything is real on the internet, Dad. Including on you. Don't believe everything you see on YouTube.
Don't lie.
Right. I'm going to do a cheat method for this. I'm gonna pop this back out. I'll show you the reason why. It doesn't want to go into the hole. Right. Still clear. So, for some reason, with this, these new ones, there's 2 points right on the edge. So right there and right there, for some reason they're like from the factory or whatever, wherever they came from, they're tacked on. And that's sort of stopping it from going down. So sliding down into the hole. So what I'm gonna do is try and break it. Right. So I've just split that down so that it's pointing down a bit sharp now, the weld a bit sharper. So it should go down further into the hole now. So, what are you taking a photo of me for? Will IS? Further. Always use plastic tools for this because you will regret it if you use metal. All right. Lining it up to where the hole's supposed to be, shutting it down. Right, sliding it back a bit so that I can see where the hole is. I think we're in. We'll find out in a minute. Alright, it's finally started going in. Now we just do very light taps to lock it into place. Making sure that the metal clip on the up top bit stays where it's supposed to be. Right, we're pretty much good there. Now we can remove this end one, get rid of this tape. Right, we'll remove this end one, and then we get the quarter window in. Now this is where it gets messy, maybe not messy, but this is the part that has the biggest risk of scratching. So what I'm going to do, just as a precaution, a bit of masking tape on the top of this top strip. There's a tab on the end here as well. Spend that down. What I'll do is get that secure, wrap that around this to keep it strapped down. Right. Same for this side. Okay. remember, a lot of this chrome strip here will be actually covered by the rubber. So there's always a risk of scratching it, but if it does get scratched, it's not the end of the world. Right. No, I'm talking about the chrome. That might be a good idea too. Putting tape on the, well, I won't bother putting it on this side so that you can sort of see how I do it, but. All right, so here we go. We've got another can of lanolin spray because some idiot head decided to. Lubrication always helps. Now, basically what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go in like that, and then this bit here is going to wedge into here, and then it's going to slide in. So what I'll do, I'll cut this screw. And then the hard part will be, because this is narrower than normal, this bit here will definitely not go in properly. So this is worst case scenario right here. I'm gonna pause the video. How far have I gone? 17 minutes. And then, let's do it. Right. Time to finally do it. Do it. So we have the quarter window here. The goal is to, basically we're gonna go in on an angle and then push it in this way and with this aluminium strip going in between here. So there's gonna be some assistance needed with the gap here because it's way too small, so we will be using tools. So basically, before we start, get some tape. Just along here, give it a little bit of protection. Right. So this is a bit weird. You've got to sort of twist this in while you're going through. So go over the rubber. Oop. It's a bit dry. Oils. Get it nice and slippery. Right. Now it's basically just wiggling it in, making sure that you're about to clear. Now this is where it gets tricky. Right. Just watch, so slide it in to about here. Make sure the rubbers are clear. So it'll be about here when it starts to. So now what we have to do is stretch this panel out so that it will slide in. So we get the thick plastic. This step, normally what you can do is, this is generally wide enough to get the aluminium in between. If you can see there, you want that channel in, but because it's way too wide, we'll have to stretch it out to be able to get it started. And as we tap it across with a hammer along here, we'll be making sure that the outside trim is not flicking up and going into the back part. Or going into the panel itself. Right. Plastic. So, hard plastic tool from bloody super cheap, or where do you get these from normally? The plastic trim.
Yeah, you can get them
super cheap. Handy remover, super cheap, or whatever equivalent?
Rip-cut.
No, the equivalent in the America.
Oh, yeah.
Harbor Freight.
Oh, O'Brien's.
O'Brien. Right. This is going to be hard. Getting it in there, widening it. Right. Just started it. Now, I'll say it again, doesn't matter if you scratch the hell to hell and back of the inside of this channel, because you don't see it. Scratch the Right. Now, when you're getting this bit in here, you want to get the top of this aluminium strip in. You can see it's like touch. You probably can't see, but it's touching right on the top there. So we need a hook tool to stretch the panel out. To get it in. Like so. So now that that's in, so now we can get to, we're up to the stage where we can just start tapping it across. Just light taps. And at this point, we remove all the masking tape. Because if I can, hang on, let's just bloody. Let's just remove the glue. Right. So on this bit here, you hardly see it because the rubber goes over it. So you just want to be peeling that back. You don't need this anymore. So this should stay where it is, because as this gets pushed forward, keeps that set into place. Same for this side, just remove the tape because you hardly see much of that strip anyway. Like that. Do the same for the top. Why didn't I just bloody grab the GoPro out instead of moving the thing out in the first place? Jeez, I'm a big... Oh, bad word. TOS. Wait, no, I don't think that's... Anyway. Oh, jeez. Right. Give it some light taps. This is where we'll be using the hook tool now. Where's my tappy whacking machine? Right. Just light taps. Making sure you're not catching any of the trim, the aluminium trim anyway. So you can see there, you need to go in a bit further. Now we'll get the hook tool, sort of spreading the rubber out. You want all the weight of the rubber, you want all the put rubber. Oh, words. You want to be putting all the pressure on the rubber instead of the panel itself. So you're just slightly peeling it back enough to get it over the lip. Same on the bottom. Probably can't see, but yeah, you're just following it along. Making sure that you're protecting the aluminium. Like so, tap on a bit more. I've just made a very big mistake, but I will show you in a minute. Yes, a mistake.
As Julia Roberts would say, that is a big mistake.
Who? What?
Have you seen that movie?
Julia Roberts?
Yeah, Pretty Woman.
Pretty Woman, yeah.
Yeah, she goes into the jewelry store.
Jewelry
store dressed as a prostitute.
Right.
And they wouldn't serve her. And she walks out to that
jewelry store. Okay, well, listen, this is a video about assembling a door. Right. Now, a good thing to do when disassembling these, well, basically, when you're disassembling this door, you're basically doing it in the reverse order that I'm assembling it. Sounds simple enough, but there are very specific screws that screw into certain areas to protect it. Stuff that's quite hard to find, you'd be surprised. And one of those is a screw that screws this plate in. Now, I usually keep it in where it comes out of, just so it doesn't get lost, but I've actually forgotten to take it out. So, how do we solve this problem? We just get a bit of a screwdriver, just lever that out a bit. Right. See? But it's a really, hang on, I'll quickly take it out. Phillips head. Doing this job, make sure you allow an hour for just trying to find tools. No. They're gonna have to start the video and then find out what they need themselves. I'll do a quick video after I've done this with all the shit. All the tools you need to finish. Right, just a tiny screw, please get in focus. It's about the size of your fingernail, and that's obviously screws on that top piece up there. So just bend the tab back around. Very soft, so you can do it with your finger. And then now these screws, because I prefer to use old ones, that you can see it's a bit rusted. So to solve that, if you got to use the same stuff, always squirt a bit of lanolin oil. Got another can because I ruined the old one. Same stuff really. So just squirt a bit on there, squirt a bit in the hole that it's meant to go in. Don't. The corrosion inhibitor is more important than the lubricant part in this situation. So even brand new tools, brand new screws and that, you're always better off squirting it in the old holes.
gonna find another screwdriver for that.
Where's my bit? Oh, right here. I'm just gonna use this. It's a bit overkill, but I can line it up a lot better.
If you couldn't tell. Oh, there it goes.
Guys, joke of the day. What's worth it? What's worse? I sounded like bloody the boxer then. What's worse than a straight pipe V6 Commodore? Nothing. It's a trick question. It's not a.
Okay. What do you mean straight pipe? There's no pipe on that thing.
What sounds worse than a no pipe V6?
A no pipe. Right. That's been screwed in. Now. Because this has been altered. So basically you got that one screw to go on the top. And the one that goes on the bottom is a bolt. So as you can see, it's a bit bloody. It's a bit crappy. All this aftermarket stuff is, something's bound to not line up. So we'll get an M6 and a washer. Oh, we'll need a bigger washer. Get that washer lined up in there. Get that started. We will get the bit, which is over there. Whoa, 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 whoa. I have blue suits. Right, starting to look like a real door now. So next stage is the felt channels. Now, as is with the same as general doors, whether or not you
use glue is up to you. I prefer to not use glue because you don't need it. So this is like, if everything's brand new, it should be made good enough to sort of clip in there, and that's that. It shouldn't. The glass is obviously going to stop it, but what you can do is set everything in when all the felt is all clipped in and everything. You can peel this side, wind the window down, peel this side out, get some contact adhesive on the bottom, and then stick it back in. So this goes in all the way to the top. Just getting the hook tool in here, making sure this
is the felt channel is hooked in all the way along. When you're putting the fitting the glass in and everything, it's I don't know where I was going there. Right, that's in. Now we can put in this final clip. So that'll go in there. We'll need the plastic trim tool. Yeah, you just got to wind the window up to do that. Right. That clips in. That went in so much easier. Thankfully. Right. What was I doing now? Yeah. Oh yeah, okay, felt channel. Now, this is a bit of a pain because if you don't line it up properly, it obviously is going to look wrong. So first thing we'll do is we are going to get this glass, the glass, and basically shift it so that it's set into this channel. So basically lifting it up, looking at it from this, lifting it on the inside and dragging it across. So get it so that it's... Get it. Right. I may as well take it off again so you can look. Right. So... the glass is sitting in the channel like that. You can see on that side there's nothing there. Normally there's a I'm not actually sure what models they that have them, but there's a channel that runs in that clip that I showed you earlier on fits onto there. Now that I think about it, it's been removed. There should be something there. Okay. Well, didn't have it on there, so... ooh, that's a bit... Alright, we'll just run with it. Didn't have it on there, so... I'll see if it's on the other door. Ugh. Right. Don't know if you can see it, but there's a tab up there. Right about there. Hard to see, but so that keeps it all guided, but it's not in the car for some reason. Got no idea where it is.
Goes missing over 50 years.
Well, the problem is it's been removed.
Not by us.
Yeah, but... so... basically what that means is there's no support on the inside... on this inside glass once it's wound down. Okay. I will continue regardless and we'll see how, if we get to the point where the window's wound down and it's moving around too much, then we'll sort that out if something happens anyway. We'll,
Who knows? Well, I know, but it'll take too long to explain.
All right, let's continue. We will get the main fault line in now. Oh, quickly. Quickly.
What in heck?
Right, so with this, you want to imagine that the panel, to stop it, to stop this from being too far in or out, line it up here against the outside of where
the spring plate angles, right.
So you want that lined up there on the edge, because you know that's exactly where it's going to sit. So then you also know that this is where the curve starts. So starting here, get the sharp curve. Like so. Keep that straight. Have a look at that. Right, that's okay, it needs to be a bit sharper though. Right, I can tell now that that's pretty good. Now this is where we go in, slide it in from, it's always start on this side, sliding it in there, use lubrication if needed. Keep going in until it's lined up with where the curve is. Like so. In a bit further. Right. Right. It's about right. So starting off here, crimping it down, making sure that the felt channel goes in between the clips. This is going to be a bit harder because it's narrower. Just don't get on this side, get it on here. So. Shouldn't need to use any more than your fingers getting this trim in. Right, that's pretty good. You probably didn't even see me do that because the camera twisted. Right, now if you've assembled this while it's hooked up, hooked on the frame, hooked up to the car itself, I salute you because it's so much more difficult. Well, we're at the point now where getting this piece on is a lot easier when the door is hooked up. So you want, I'll show you, pull this off. Now, if you've got someone to help you do this, it's a lot easier. But if you don't, then this is how you pick it up. I've just got, gonna put some brand new stainless bolts on there. Right. Now you'll need a small screwdriver and the rattle gun or the hammer drill or whatever you fancy with the bit on it. It has just disappeared. Can't find anything. Alright, I'll find it and then be right back. Right. So, small screwdriver and a little hammer drill with what your bit is. Oh my god, I got the wrong size. That's the right size. Right. Boom, boom, boom. So have everything ready. Having a drill bit with one in ready to go. Leverage or something. Like I said, definitely do not recommend this if you've got someone to help you. So just line it up, screwdriver into the guide, and just dropping it down will lift up the hole. Bend very carefully without dropping the screw. Get one started. Take it out. Do the same for the other side. Like so. Screw in. We've got two on, they are loose but they're on. Get the other ones started at least. Right. Just give them a nip. Probably didn't see much of that, but so there you go. It's give it a quick test to make sure that nothing's hitting.
As you can see,
massive gap here, small gap there.
So,
and that's pretty much lined up. So what you need is, that means I need a packer on the bottom to bring this back of this door up. But won't do that for now, I'll just sit it there. Now this is gonna be fun to film.